It is the intervention of the House that has stalled the expenditure of that money for that, so that contrived SME fund. That's part of why it hasn't been spent. Another aspect of it is it has actually been spent gradually in a process which now involved giving consultancies to the tune of 8.5 million to administer a fund that barely 400 people have benefited from, according to the records they gave us. Now, there was another project called the AVDD. I actually thought the vice president's, you know, assistant here was going to address that issue, and it was superintended by the vice president's office. Even that took funds from this GEM project funds that were available, and the beneficiaries, as we speak, have still not received the second tranche of what is supposed to be given to them.
We're gonna dig a bit deeper into some of those allegations in a moment. Mr. Osakwe, let me ask you, obviously you've been a beneficiary of this project. Can you give us a sense of how you have benefited from this project and what your thoughts are on some of the allegations made by Honorable Mark Bila?
Okay, thank you very much. I'd like to start from where the whole project started. I'm part of the AVDD, as he mentioned, and 30 people were allowed to pitch to the president in Asavilu. After that, another 51 were added to the list from the other companies that actually applied for the program. Now, all of us actually now formed a group where we could actually follow up on our businesses. And I would say that upon receiving the first tranche, a lot of us actually made serious expansions. A lot of people that were working from home, I was working from home, I was able to get a factory set up, and we were able to start producing what we need to produce. Now, where we had a problem is the federal government became our financial partner. And from the grant agreement, we were supposed to meet a particular milestone in 3 months, after which we'll be given the second tranche to continue. And the program was supposed to last for 1 year, which is between 4th of April of 2017 to 4th of April 2018. But at some point, we kind of lost communication with the GEM project. We were not getting the emails we needed to know what was actually happening, why there were delays and all that. In fact, one of us was disqualified from receiving the second tranche because she left the country at the point when PwC came for inspection. She had a Ford Foundation scholarship, study scholarship that she went for. And by the time she got back, they had come to her factory, and of course, her staff were not able to defend it the way she would have defended it. So these are the things that happened. And we are still waiting for the second tranche. Some people have been paid, no doubt. About 13 people have received their second tranche, and that's mostly people that are in Abuja, because they were the first to get the second evaluation from PIU. But the rest of us now got worried about the whole situation, because we understood that the whole contract is ending by tomorrow, and we're wondering, no communication, nothing. So we started asking questions, and that is why we're here. Some of the information he gave down are just coming to us for the first time, because we were mostly kept in the dark.
Honorable member, one of the issues you've raised is the role of Minister of Finance, Kemi Adeosun, in regards to some of the issues around the disbursement of the funds. You've said that various states around the country have tried to access the fund for beneficiaries within their states, within those states, have tried unsuccessfully, and that you feel that it's being intentionally held up from the point of the minister's office. Can you expatiate on that idea?
Okay, now, the funds being held up actually aren't directly the fault of the Minister of Finance, but as the ministry that superintends the funds, she is expected to ensure that the project is administered in line with the provisions of the project framework itself. Now, that is where she has, in my opinion, failed in our responsibility, including the World Bank. because it has now been left in the hands of the supervising, or rather the ministry where the project is domiciled. That is the Ministry of Industry, Trade and Investment, for the minister to administer at will, which he now does directly with the assistance, of course, controversially again, with one of his special assistants in his office. Now, you see, now this is the kind of lack of transparency, in our opinion, that has been going on in this entire project, something that we felt was a laudable project for our teeming youth. I just came back from my constituency. You can look at the dismay, you know, on the faces of the youth when they have nothing to look forward to. One of the beneficiaries of the AVDD was a former schoolmate of mine. That's how come I even got aware of it. And it would interest you to know, when the investigations commenced in the House, that the minister asked people in the GEM project to swear an oath of secrecy. Now, isn't that weird?
No, we have...
This is a fact that you can cross-check.
We have heard from the minister's office. We've reached out to them, and they've made it clear to us that they will appear on subsequent editions of this program to clear the air from their vantage point.
And
I think that's very important to note, because right now we are discussing allegations that are not yet fully substantiated. So.